each game ball tonight will be very similar in the way of procedure. You'll watch the 30-second board. Once you see that, you realize if you have any kind of problem, you gotta have your hand in the air, and the hands are gone at 30 seconds, you are on your own. Once it turns to five, that game will fall to the ground for 5 until 10 seconds. Interesting start tonight. When they come off the start gate, they go down into turn number one. They make a hard left-hander. It's an oval. It's an oval track. They go into a left-hander over that little triple ripple, right back into another 180 turn, and then
evening. Because the circuit at Daytona is unique, it always gets a lot of attention. Gary Bailey was a pioneer of this sport, rode in the first Daytona Supercross. That was relatively late in his career, and it wasn't called Supercross back then. He retired, he started a motocross school, and he began making the lives of the competitors miserable by designing the Daytona course. He's done it now for 30-odd years, and we spent a few minutes talking to the professor about the challenge of building the track and the challenge it presents to the riders.
The guys that win here are the tough ones. They're the guys that are physically fit, and it's pretty much been through, I mean, hey, we got Ricky Carmichael, who's pretty much dominated this thing here pretty well, and Jeff Stanton, who dominated here. And if I had more to say about exactly how it was built, I would actually build it a little tougher and throw in a couple of obstacles. I remember the old days when if there was a sheer wall there, nobody complained about it, nobody whined, today everybody's like, well, it's not just like the other ones, and it's not perfect, and it's, but I don't know, never know that everything had to be exactly perfect, you know? I mean, if it's different and it's more of a challenge, so as long as it's safe, that's my thing. I want to build it as tough as possible, but as safe as possible.
Ensure that the Daytona Supercross will be unlike any other on the circuit. That makes the track and its builder an easy target for the critics.
I decided to soften it up, and I heard more complaining that one year that I softened it up from the riders going, what's the matter, Bailey? You're getting soft in your old age, and da-da-da-da-da. And I thought, well, you know what? That's the last time I think I'm ever going to hear that. So I'm going to make sure that I try and keep it just as rough as possible. So they seem to always complain at first when they first get here, and they're walking the track, and they complain about it. At the end of the day, most people are going, hey, you know what? The track came out pretty good. It's actually pretty nice. I kind of liked it. You know, and you know, the interesting thing was when my son David was racing, every year he'd get here, he hated the racetrack. He'd always go, Dad, you want to change this? And I go, I'm building the racetrack, you're racing, shut up.
Long, rough, and sandy, the Daytona layout is a unique challenge on the Supercross circuit, and Bailey puts the emphasis on challenge.
I like to try and build things a little bit different than all the other Supercrosses, just for the fact that I want to see how the guys handle those situations differently. So, and I always want to try and keep it Daytona. I don't ever want to try and get it exactly like the other Supercrosses, if it's all possible. My sand whoops are definitely the personalized thing, and I usually build at least two sections of them, sometimes three, and trying to make them a little bit of a variety.
For Bailey, this is all sort of personal. He raced Daytona the first 4 years it ran. A decade later, in 1984, he watched his son David win the big race. Last year, he presided over the first night race in Daytona Supercross history. And tonight, as this American classic celebrates another anniversary, we say thanks to the professor, Gary Bailey, for 35 years of great memories.
What's going to happen when I'm not building anymore at Daytona? I don't really know. It'll probably change when I'm not building it, because somebody's going to come in with a whole new, different idea of how you build things and how the layout is. I just have no idea. It's an interesting thought, but I know one thing. Me and my buddy Don Flaner, that helps me build the track, we decided that the first year that I'm not building the Daytona track, we're coming to Daytona, and we're going to be the full-on spectators. We're going to just come out and just have a great time and just bring our street bikes down here and really enjoy what Bike Week is really all about.
On those Bull Tacos back in the day, or on the Bulldozer these days, that guy has made some huge contributions to this sport, and we are abundantly blessed with Baileys, aren't we? We have that one who built the track, and we have his son, David, up in the booth. What do you think, guys? What kind of job has he done this year?
Oh, I love it. You know, and as like you said, it's so true, and it's funny that I love hearing him say, shut up, because I totally remember that. And actually, that was the year that I won. But typically, like you said, you walk the track, and you're like, yeah, it could be a little wider here. This could have been different. This year is the best track that I've ever seen.
Here at Top of the Tower, so you can watch these two guys for the last 5 to 10 years. The amateur world is the first driver. 5 seconds. We are running out of the head towards the first. The first here at Daytona.
Now look at Wickham. He is now on the bottom. Yeah. mistakes the 2 hours before that race.
Don't forget the stuff in the truck, buddy.